गेट रेडी फॉर द डिक्टेशन स्टार्ट दिस अपील अराइजेज फ्रॉम ए जजमेंट ऑफ ए डिवीजन बेंच ऑफ द हाई कोर्ट ऑफ आंध्र प्रदेश डेटेड 3 अगस्त 2019 द हाई कोर्ट हैज अफर्म्ड द कन्विक्शन ऑफ द अपीलेंट फॉर ऑफेंसेस पनिशेबल अंडर सेक्शन 3-5 ऑफ द शेड्यूल्ड कास्ट एंड द शेड्यूल्ड ट्राइब्स Prevention of Atrocities Act 1989 and Section 376(1) of the Indian Penal Code. The appellant has been sentenced to suffer imprisonment for life for each of the above offences, the substantive sentences being directed to run concurrently. In addition, the appellant has been sentenced to pay a fine of ₹1,000 for each of the offences and in default to suffer imprisonment of 6 months. The appellant was residing in Gajulapalli village and was engaged in carrying out manual work for 2 years prior to the incident. PW2, who is blind since birth, used to live with her mother PW1 and brother PW3. PW3 and LW5 are the sons of PW1. They were also engaged in manual work together with the appellant at the same place. The appellant, according to the prosecution, lived in the same village and regularly visited the house of PW1 due to his acquaintance with her sons. At about 9 a.m. on 31 March 2011, PW1 was attending to her household chores at a public tap which was within a distance of 50 feet and her sons were cutting firewood in the vicinity. The appellant is alleged to have inquired about her sons when PW1 replied that her spouse and sons were chopping firewood and asked him to wait for a while. After half an hour, on hearing the voice of her daughter PW2 in distress, she rushed to the house and found that the door was locked from inside. Upon raising an alarm, her husband and sons rushed to the house. The appellant opened the door and tried to escape but was apprehended at the spot. Upon entering the house, PW1 observed that PW2 was lying on the ground in a nude condition and was bleeding from her genitals. The clothes of PW2 were torn and stained with blood. Upon inquiry, PW2 is alleged to have stated that the appellant came to the house and inquired about her brothers. He locked the door and fell on her, gagged and raped her. The case of the prosecution is that at 10 a.m. the sub-inspector of police PW9 Mahanandi police station, who received a call from PW4, a cousin of PW1, rushed to the scene of the occurrence. By that time, the circle inspector of police Nandyal rural police station had also arrived and the villagers handed over the appellant to him. PW1 furnished a written report to the police which was registered as crime number 28/2011. PW11 sent the victim to the government hospital where she was examined by PW10, the civil surgeon at the district hospital. The medical examination revealed that PW2 was blind. The medical report of the examination of PW2 has been extracted in the judgment of the Sessions Judge and the High Court and reads as follows. Stop.